I know that you've been studying elections in your government class, how you talk about how election day is on the first Tuesday after a Monday in November, how you need to register, all that sort of stuff. Well, a lot of it's still true, but this year things are going to look a little bit different throughout the country and right here in Jefferson County. So here are 10 things you need to know about how to vote in Jefferson County in 2020. Thing number one, qualifications. Are you a citizen of the United States? Are you 18 years old, or will you be 18 by November 3rd? If so, guess what? You're eligible to vote. Number two, registration. In order to vote, you have to be registered. Are you registered to vote? Well, go to govoteky.com to register to vote. Do you think maybe you did it earlier, but you don't really remember? That's okay. You can still go to that website and you can check the status of your registration. But if you're not registered, you must be registered by October 5th. That's the deadline. No registration, no vote. So get it done. Number three, options. This year, when you cast your ballot, you've got three options. You can vote by mail. This is also known as voting absentee. You can vote in person early, or you can vote on election day. Number four, voting by mail. You can request an absentee ballot by going to govoteky.com. Once your ballot arrives in the mail, be sure to read all the instructions carefully. You would hate to have your ballot thrown out because you didn't sign it in the correct places or use the correct envelope. Number five, returning your absentee ballot. The easiest way to return your ballot is once you get it in the mail, read the instructions, fill it out, and return it by dropping it back in the mailbox. But you must have it postmarked by November 3rd, Election Day, so don't wait until the last moment. I recommend filling it out and returning it as soon as possible to make sure that it is received. If you'd rather return your ballot in person so as not to overwork your mail carrier or overload the postal service, you can do that by dropping off your ballot at any number of ballot drop boxes that are located throughout the county. Information about where to find these ballot drop boxes will be located in the description below. Number six, early in-person voting. In an effort to avoid long lines and reduce crowds, you now have the option to vote at one of four different early voting polling locations located throughout the city. These polling locations will be open from October 13th through November 2nd, but be sure to swing by between the hours of 8:30 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. These four locations will also be available on Election Day during regular voting hours. Number seven, voting on Election Day. As you've probably discussed in class, ordinarily voters go to a polling location located relatively close to their house and vote in their particular precinct. Well, this year things are looking a little bit different. Because of the prevalence of early voting and so many people voting by mail, there will be fewer polling locations throughout the county. This year, there will be 20. You can choose to go and vote at any of these 20 polling locations, regardless of where you live. The important part is that you stop by between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. to cast your one vote. Information about where to find these polling locations is located in the description below. Number eight, be patient. With so many people in our state and across the country voting by mail, and with so many of those mail-in ballots being sent a few days before Election Day or on Election Day, it will take a while for local election officials to receive, verify, and count all of those ballots. What does this mean? It means in many races, including some very big races, we may not know who the winner is on election night. It may take 2, 3 days before we have a clearer picture about who won. This should be expected, and it's nothing to be concerned about. So be patient. Number nine, a message for those of you who can't vote. Chances are many of you watching this video aren't even eligible to vote this year. You're not old enough. And so, yeah, you can't vote, and that kind of stinks. But that doesn't mean you can't be involved. You can volunteer with a campaign. You could use your social media platform in a positive way to let people know why voting is important and let them know how they can get involved. But maybe most importantly, you can talk to the people in your life, people who are older than you, who care about you, about why you think voting is important and let them know what issues you care about. You may be surprised how much influence you can have on a parent, a grandparent, an older sibling, because they care about you, so let them know what you care about. Number 10, remember that your vote matters, and don't let anyone tell you that it doesn't. It's very easy to become jaded, cynical, and frustrated with the political process. But the important part to remember is that all those people in positions of power, at the end of the day, they are accountable to you and me, the ordinary citizens of this country. Voting is the most effective way to let them know what you care about. This is true whether you're voting for president, senator, and it's even more true when you're voting for state and local offices. Most of the decisions that affect your day-to-day life are made by those folks, and in those races, your single vote has a lot more weight. So please don't waste your opportunity to have your voice heard.